and I, welcome back to Angels Light Tarot. Thank you, thank you, thank you for stopping by for your weekly general message for August the 3rd through August the 9th. And of course, we are starting with your lovebird bonus for those of you who are in a beautiful, beautiful romantic bond. Now, remember, this is just a sneak peek. Just a sneak peek for 7 little days. Be sure to check the playlist for your August love reading. Angels and guys, positive energy for those of you who are in a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful love bond. We have creativity and portals. Where do we play? In nature. That's where the garden gate will take you there. I definitely feel like you guys are gonna do something totally wacko, something totally fun, something, you know, you haven't done anything like this for quite some time. I don't want to hear what it is. Nope, I don't. Keep it to yourself. Okay, Gemini. Now, moving on to, yes, 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 singles love, angels and guides, positive energy. We're looking for the love that's around single Gemini for 7 little days. Okay, so we have love. Yes, we do, with four-leaf clover. You have found a four-leaf clover. Unlucky times will soon be over. So I'm just gonna tell you, love is on its way. Don't go looking for it. It's gonna find you. Okay, so Gemini, let's get into your general message for August the 3rd through August the 9th. Angels and guides, positive energy, please. Positive energy. Yes, 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 for Gemini. What is going on? What is going on for Gemini? Positive energy. We're looking for positive energy. Yes, we are moving on to the purple deck. There's a lot of bonus here for you, Gemini. What's going on here, Gemini? What is going on? You're like, I don't know. You're like, I don't know. That's why I'm listening to you. Okay, I know. Just keep on working, Dora. Just keep on working. Angels and guides, positive energy. Looking for some high vibration, some joy for Gemini. Yes, yes, yes. Positive energy for Gemini for, yes, 7 little days. Let's add my mama's deck, shall we? Come on, angels. Positive energy, please. For lovely, lovely, lovely Gemini. Come on, angels. What's going on for Gemini for 7 little days? Just 7 little days. Positive energy, please. Positive energy for Gemini. Yes, yes, yes. Ooh, well, that's nice. Well, that's nice. You're like, what's nice? What's nice? Well, that's nice. Yeah, there we go. There we go. Moving on to, yes, yes, yes. I feel like we need the Angels of Light deck, the Angels of Light deck, to shine the light on this message. Okay, I'm almost done. Now remember, guys, remember, if this is taking too long, you know what to do. Yeah, you know what to do. Yeah, you take that little button. Yep, that's it. Move it. Just move it over. Angels and guides, positive energy. We're almost there. We're all, thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you. Thank you, angels. I know. We can't take forever, right? Yeah, I'm talking to myself. Positive energy. Thank you, thank you, thank you. What in Pete's name, Gemini, is going on here? This is, okay, all right, I think that's it. Let's get right into this because, boy, oh boy, what is this? All right, so major theme for the week is the Emperor reverse. Yes, yes, yes. Partnership and alliances. The Chariot card. The 6 of Hearts. The 10 of Diamonds. Angel of Sweet Delight, King of Spades, and the Joker. So what I'm feeling is the Emperor card reverse is telling me that, you know, you don't have to, it's almost like this fight is not for you. It's not. This is not your fight. That's all I'm, this is not your fight, right? This is, yes, choose your battles, because I feel like, I think that's very important this week, to choose your battles. Everything is not a war, okay, Gemini? With the Chariot card, things are definitely progressing. It's like, no nitpicking, or vice versa. They shouldn't nitpick on you, because you're all about the partnership this week. You're all about the peace. You know what? Well, you know what? You're like, what? That peace is going to bring abundance, financial abundance to you. And you know what? Sweet delight. Isn't that delightful? With the King of Spades, you have worked for this. You have worked for this with the Joker, and you're like, whew, it's finally here. I didn't expect it, but it's finally here. Now, when we look at your recent past, okay, you have the Chariot card with the Light card and the Shaman in the recent past with the Eight of Diamonds, the Three of Clubs, and the Angel of Virtue, the Two of Clubs, and the Six of Hearts. So in the recent past, I definitely see something was coming towards you. What was it? Oh, it was the light. Yeah, like the lights are on, right? You started to have an understanding, a deep understanding with the Shaman card. And it looked like that understanding had something to do with money, resources. You were a bit worried about it. With the Angel of Virtue, I see that no matter, even though you were worried, you were still feeling like, I need to do the right thing here. With the Two of Clubs, there may have been a little bit of an argument in reference to it, but you still, with the Six of Hearts, you still were honorable, if that makes sense, to your obligations. Now, when we look in the middle of the week, I think I have to sneeze. Maybe not. Okay, so in the middle of the week, we have the Lovers card with the Solitude and the Temperance card with the Seven of Hearts with the Queen of Clubs and the Angel of Radiance, the Three of Spades, and the Three of Hearts. What's going on here? So I definitely feel like there is someone in your world that you love dearly. And this looks like romance, but it could be, but depending on your circumstance, it might be someone that you love dearly. Your mother, your brother, your sister, your cousin, your uncle, your best friend, whoever this is, you love this person dearly. I feel like with the Solitude card, maybe you guys are doing things together, one-on-one, right? And that is bringing balance into your world. I feel like you're being non-attached to the rest of the world, if that makes sense. And you're feeling like with the Queen of Clubs, I feel like you're like tapped in emotionally, spiritually. You're tapped in, and I feel like you're tapped in with this other person, if that makes sense. Tapped in as in psychically connected. I feel you're psychically connected. And it's kind of like you're away from the rest of the world. With the Angel of Radiance, I feel like you like it that way or they like it that way. With the Three of Clubs, there is a bit of worry about the Three of Hearts, about having other people around you, if that makes sense. It's not a bad thing. It's just an is thing. Like maybe you're spending a lot of time with just one person and you're like, I really would like to spend time with this person, and I want to have company. That's all I'm saying, right? No, or I want to go out with my friends. Okay, so I'm going to move on to the end of the week. Now, when we look at the end of the week, we have the Nine of Pentacles reversed with the Shadow card and the Light, the Eight of Shells, yes, with the Queen of Diamonds, the Queen of Spades, the Angel of Transformation, the Seven of Spades, and the Eight of Diamonds. So I feel like by the end of the week, your resources, I feel like, They're good, okay? They're good, but you know, they could be better. You're like, I'm in charge of my money, but I'm looking at my bank account, I'm thinking, they're all right, but it could be better. But you know, it can always be better, right? With the Shadow card, there's something, I feel like you're thinking with your resources, it's just something not right. Maybe I need to tweak something. With the Eight of Shells, I feel like there is a renewal. There is a renewal when it comes to your resources. It's making you. You're like, what's the renewal? Yeah, the renewal. You know what? I need to know what's the renewal. What is the renewal? Angels, what's the renewal? Oh, there's a change in feelings. There's a change in feelings when it comes to your resources. And I feel like with the Queen of Diamonds, this change in feelings is going to, you know, it's feeling like making you feel like you're more powerful in your finances. And it's coming through the inner you. It's like you change something within you. You shift a thought, a feeling, a desire within you, and then other things change, right? With the, yes, you can't make this up. With the angel of transformation, you create a change by changing something within you. And you're like, that's not real, Dora. Okay, it's real. If you decide that, and I'm not, hypothetically speaking, if you come to terms with, if you say, you know what? I have $1,000 in my bank account. Let's hypothetically speak in, and you say, you know what? That's not enough. That's just not enough, right? Or you say, I have $1,000 in my bank account and I am feeling good. Okay, so that part right there, that's gonna attract more abundance to you because your vibration is now high enough for, yeah, that energy to come in. You know what I'm saying, Gemini. So believe and practice. Oh my God, you can't make this up. Okay, I'm just saying, believe. The Seven of Spades is saying believe with the Eight of Diamonds in the abundance that is coming your way, okay? And you're like, so when you tell me at the end of the month there was a check, at the end of the week there was a check that came in or some money came in, we'll talk, okay? All right, now, when we look at your bonus, you have the nine of swords with the three of swords and the six of swords reversed with the eight of wands, the page of pentacles, the hope card, and the world card. Yes, yes, yes. The ace of clubs, the seven of diamonds, angel of masculinity, two of spades. I told you this was a lot. With the nine of diamonds. So I feel like there is something that's keeping you up at night. Yeah, you are definitely worried sick. Okay, worried sick about this. Now, I feel like whatever it is, I feel like it's a return of something. It could be a return of a person. It could be a return of a situation. But I feel like the return of the situation, it's going to bring back news that isn't as bad as you think. Yeah, okay, so you were worrying. With the Page of Pentacles, it looks like it may have something to do with someone younger, or maybe someone younger with, I feel like, someone younger, definitely. I feel like it's someone younger, but you have hope for this person. You definitely have hope for this person. You feel like, you know what? I feel like things are not as bad as you think they are. And I feel like this hope that you have is working in your favor because I feel like there is a celebration. It's waiting. Yeah, it's celebration, and you're like, hey, I wasn't thinking about that. There's no way in the world I would have been thinking about that. With the seven of diamonds, practice non-attachment once again, and money will fall in your lap. With the angel of masculinity, and then take your power back in all of your partnerships. Whatever you need to let go of with the nine of diamonds, go ahead, let it go, because it looks like you have you've tapped into some spiritual money, okay? I'm just telling you, the more you release the desire, the need, I gotta get, as soon as you get into that, you know what? Everything is coming to me, or I have everything that I need, and you are happy about that. All of a sudden, yeah, it keeps coming in, and you're like, hey, I got a check in the mail, or hey, I found money on the ground, or yes, okay, now you get it. Okay, Gemini, I send you joy, namaste, and much, much love sent your way.